Welcome, my name is Oliver, to our first Archaos Media Master training. We are going to look today to the preference menu. The preference menu can be accessed in the file and selecting preferences. When the menu opens, you will see some different tabs there. We have the first tab is the mode tab. Here you will be selecting the type of mode you will be using, simple or fixture mode. In the second tab, you will be able to change the full screen monitor. This means your output device, and in this list the graphical cards installed on your system will be displayed. The resolution speaks for itself. You can select any resolution out of the list, or of course give in a custom resolution as needed. In the multi-monitor arrangement, you can say if the screens are horizontal, vertical, double horizontal or double vertical. There is beneath that a force resolution button. If you activate this, all of the graphical power from your graphical card will be centralized to that from MediaMaster. The engine accuracy, we have three options. It's minimal, buffered and frame blending. Minimal means if you have less demanding hardware like a Celeron D or whatever, you can choose minimal. Buffered is our standard setting. This means it will buffer some frames and of course frame blending. The timing reference, again two options. The first option is the system clock. This means you are running audio with video and it will synchronize on the system clock of your system, and display, you will select this if you only have video and no sound. In the soft edge pan, you will be able to say how many rows horizontally and vertically you have to put some soft edge panning on this. The geometrical button, we will have a second training going in depth into geometrics. And our third tab is the interface tab, DMX. Here you can choose which interface you will be using, ARTnet, MANet, or, for example, a box you have connected USB to DMX. You can select your subnet, 0 to 15, your universe, 0 to 15, and the count. The count means how many universes you will use, in this case 2. The device name of your server will be displayed and the IP address. Please choose an IP address, of course, in the ARTnet range. In the patch of this menu, you will see layer fixers. Here you will find the personality files for MediaMaster to put into your console when you patch it. Also the universe, the number of layers and the start channel. So in first universe we put 8 layers, second universe 4 layers, and we start at channel 1. Beneath that you have the master fixture. This is the master fixture on your right side. Also choose the personality file, activate it, choose the universe and the start channel. In the audio tab you have some possibilities to tweak the audio settings. You can select direct sound or ASIO. You can select the input device, the output device. If you're not using audio, please put the output device on no audio. It will give you some extra processing power. The buffer size on 1024, for example. In the performance tab, you will be able to tweak the output of your screen in the preview menu. And if you're programming a show, put it on maximum. If you're running the show, you can put it less, because then you don't need it, and again have more processing power. In the LED output tab, you can make a LMP file or LED mapping file with our Archaos LED mapper and load it up here in this menu. And the last tab is of course the registration tab with your machine ID, the serial number you are provided by Archaos, the license, so the MediaMaster Pro LED in this case, and an update registration button. And today we are going to talk about setting up our basic output screens. So how do we do this? We do this in three steps. Our first step is right mouse click on the desktop, going to properties. If you select this, you will go to the settings tab, and here you will see all of your screens connected to your server or computer. Here you can change the resolution if necessary. So if I click our two output screens, you will see that I've chosen 1920 by 1080 for both of the screens. And when that's done, just click OK to confirm. Our second step we are going to do is again right mouse click, but now we are going to the NVIDIA control panel, or if you have an ATI card, to the ATI control panel. And when this opens, you will see on the left side multiple options to change the resolution and stuff like that, but we are going to set up multiple displays. In this list, you will see a list of your both of your graphical cards. We will select the second graphical card because there our output screens are connected. And then we have the following options. You can create a use only one display, use the same on both displays, as one large horizontal desktop, so a horizontal span and a vertical span. This can only be done in XP and not in Windows 7. Or configure them independently from each other. This is what I'm going to choose now. And just close it when you have done your settings. The next step is opening Media Master and going to the File menu, Preferences. Then you must go to the Display tab. When you're in the Display tab, we already explained this menu a little bit. You go to the Full Screen Monitor. Here you will see your available outputs where there are screens connected to, so the first one of your first graphical card, and the second and the third one are from your second graphical card. And also NVIDIA puts one extra in, being the both screens configured separately, as we just told in the menu from NVIDIA. So we select that one. You can use a custom resolution, or you can use a resolution out of the list. So we'll just select one out of this list. Then you have to say if it's a multi-monitor arrangement. Yes, of course, because we have two monitors and they are horizontally from each other. Put the force resolution on. I always put my engine accuracy to frame blending and the timing reference. If you use video with sound, you will use system clock. Otherwise, you will just select display. In our soft touch pen, you can say two horizontal and one vertical screens and click OK to confirm these settings. Now, how can you see that you have done the correct settings? Just go to display and toggle full screen. And then you can mount some visuals, so you will see these visuals running on your outputs. Today we will be talking about basic soft edging in Archaos Media Master Pro and Express, of course. On the right side of your screen you have the master layer. And here you have two buttons, the white and the curve. White and curve settings for multiple screen outputs. When using the multiple screen output, these controls will allow you to configure the blending zone between two projectors. The white sets the size of the overlapping strip, and the curve defines how strong a soft edge blending should be to ensure you can calibrate the overlap to a seamless image with even brightness. Now, how do we do this? It's very easy. On the right side you have this button, and it's the calibration screen button. You have the white knob. If I move this knob, you see that the lines are moving, and you can just put them on top of one another, so you have a seamless line. And then you have the curve. As you can see, I'm now changing it to be as perfect as possible. And if you release the calibration screen button, you will have a nice image without any lines in between the two projectors. And today with my colleague Quentin, we are making a video about advanced soft edging. So before we start with advanced soft edging, we need to open the Media Master Pro 2.2, and we have it running here in simple mode. So just to be clear, advanced soft edging can only be done in the Media Master Pro software in the simple or fixture mode. Before we start, you always start to try to do some soft edging with the simple version or the standard version with the white and the curve. And if this isn't enough, you can go to the File menu, Preferences, and in this menu you will take the Display tab. And we configure today a soft edge span of 3 horizontally and 1 vertically. But we only have 2 physical output screens, so just to say it's possible to put in more screens than you need. On the top you will see your 3 screens you can select. Here you have the geometrical correction, and here is the soft edge tab. On the right side on top you have this black button. If you look at our output screen on the left side, you will see that there is a kind of calibration screen that comes up. And if you want to use the custom soft edge, you just activate it here. And you copy your default values that you already did in the standard soft edging. Okay, so we selected the left screen, and my colleague will now zoom in a little bit on the left screen so I can show you exactly what we are doing. You see the three lines moving. This means I am moving the white of the right soft edge, and now I am applying a new curve. The nice thing about this, you can select the top, the bottom, the right and the left and start changing them as needed for your setup. So let me just show you guys some basic soft edging. And also the white and the curve can be different for all sides. If we select the second one, I will just show you that you can easily change that one too. And of course, every screen is separately configured. Okay, so let's say this is your soft edging you did, but you want to see it with an actual visual. Just go to the right side on top and click, and the calibration screen will disappear. And then you can see what you have done with your soft edging. So this is also very active. You can do this when you're looking at your visuals or at your layers. So it's very, very hands-on, and it doesn't take a lot of time to really do this thoroughly. So this is what soft edging is in the advanced mode. To save all of your settings, just click the close button on the right side on top and just click OK, and then you will save your soft edge settings. Today we will be talking about advanced geometrical correction. To do that, of course, we have to start up our Media Master and go to full screen mode. So as you see, I'm just doing that. We can access the geometrical correction by opening File Preferences. When the menu is open, we go to the Display tab, and then we select Geometrical Correction. When the menu is open, you see at the left top side two screens, where you can each select of your screens, and the orange border where you also can click on, and then you will have both screens at the same time. We have a magnetic border function, and here we have some buttons that I will explain to you. If you press the F1, you will be adding horizontal points into your geometrical correction, and F3 is adding vertical points. F2 is removing horizontal points, and F4 is removing vertical points. So let's add one horizontal point to keep it simple, and let's see what it does on the output. On the top left, you still have your calibration screen that you can put in, so you can see what you are doing. And my colleague will now zoom in a little bit so we can show you the geometrical correction that I am doing. So I just drag and drop a point down, and I can do it with any of the points. Click once to select it and just bring it up. It's not only in one way, you can do it in any way you want, so you can deform your screen in any size or any shape you need to project on curved screens. So this is a setup I do. For example, I will now remove my calibration screen, and then you will see the visual running on a curved setup. You can also adjust it without using it, the calibration screen, and just doing it like so. So it's not a problem. It also needs some time to calculate, of course, when you move some points. So, and when it stopped calculating, the visual will return to its normal form. Perfect. So this is how you actually will change your geometrical correction. Which types of geometrical corrections do we have? We have no correction, we have linear, and we have curved, and we have NURB. You can toy around with these depending on what, of course, you need to change. I will now select the linear one, press the reset button so our screen is just resetted. I will just add some horizontal points and some vertical points and show you what I mean. So then you have straight lines instead of curved lines, of course, that you can change, selecting a point, dragging and dropping it across, so you can actually have any form you want and still be able to edit it in a nice way. So as you see, it doesn't take a lot of effort to do that. If we select only one screen, not the orange border, but one of the blue screens, you still can adapt some changes or add some points only to that one and not to the other screen. So you can also edit each screen separately. So here I will put in some vertical points, voila, and add the vertical points, and of course change it. Now, as you can see, you can have on both screens linear, but if you select one, you can also choose curved to change it, or even NURB. So this is a little bit how our geometrical correction works. And to save this, just press the close button, the same as with the soft edging, press OK, and then wait until the system will show you the output, and then you can run some visuals if needed.